In the studio with me is a historian and public affairs analyst, Emmanuel Moloku. It's nice to have you join us right now.
Thank you, Emmanuel.
Very good. Now, when we were in school, we used to learn about the Kanem-Boronu Empire, the Oyo Empire, all of those empires at that time, and the stories of Osman Danfodio. It was beautiful. It used to be so beautiful and so on. But when history was taken away, that bracket, that period of time, not so many students learned all of those things, and it's coming back now. What impact has the taking away of history, what impact had it had in the system? You are there, so you talk to us about it.
Thank you very much. First of all, let me say good morning to Nigerians and a good morning to you presenters. And I want to make one point here. TVC is making history today by giving opportunity to talk about
Thank
history.
You.
Whatever we are going to talk today is going to be a reference point in 10, 12, 20 years coming.
Thank you.
So let me start first by, saying as a historian to thank the president for finding it germane and the Minister of Education, Adamu Adamu, for bringing history back.
Why was it removed in the first place?
How the history was removed was that, unfortunately, history. Let me start with two quotations. First was the one of Sidney Simpson, a British administrator, and Simeon Aremu, a seasoned Nigerian civil servant. He said, every situation is rooted in the past. The present is also in the past. Mm.
But what impact has that had? When they took that knowledge of understanding the past, when it was taken away, what impact did it have?
It had a terrible effect on the country. First of all, our children and the generations, we are cut off from the history. And the Spanish American historian said, anybody who does not know what has happened before he was born will forever remain a child. Hmm. So he found out that when history was taken away from the curriculum, what they were given, when the children were given, was not taking them anywhere. Because there is no profession that does not have its own historical background. Medicine has its history. If you are moved from a hospital to another, what the doctor will ask for is the history of that
history.
Medical history. Mm. So when you take away history from this, it's like you have unwittingly removed the children from their moving towards their trajectory of growth. Because a lot of things will happen. One, they will lose no sense of pride. Two, there will be no model for them to follow, to look up to. Three, there is this sense of not, if you don't discover yourself and don't know yourself, you will not know where you are going to. So these children don't even know where they are coming from.
All right, we are happy now that all Nigerians are glad now that by September, the beginning of the next session, history will be reintroduced. Yeah. We must thank you very much, Emmanuel Moloku, for coming on the program.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
Right. It's a pleasure.
In the studio with me is a historian and public affairs analyst, Emmanuel Moloku. Thank you for joining us on TVC Breakfast. Now, how important is the study of history in schools?
Yes, let me start by saying this. You know, when you remove history, you have created a vacuum. And that vacuum has to be covered because nature abhors vacuum. When they remove history, something else enters, something that was not history enters. And that is propaganda, hate speeches, and fake news. And that distorted the growth of history in the country. Then, let me give you this analogy. A train takes off from Edo here, and it's going to head into Kano. And it gets to a lorry, and you find out that the tracks from a lorry to about 100 kilometers or more have been removed. Will that train continue?
No.
Of course, the train will stop there. What happens? The passengers will get frustrated. There will be problem. And that frustration was what we are seeing today, because the history is a veritable instrument for nation building. Our journey for nation, for our national journey, was put at a stop when history was removed from the curriculum, and it did a lot of terrible things to this. All the things you've seen, all the things you've seen going on wrong in the country, talking about Boko Haram and all that. All
of them is that a result of history?
Yes, a result of the fact that we don't know our history.
Really?
Yes, we don't document history. Because if we have documented history, remember we have Mount Asene there. What is the root cause of Mount Asene? Nobody knows. How was it quelled? Nobody knows. There's no document, there's no historical distinction about it. If we have it, immediately Boko Haram started, it would have been nipping the bud.
So,
but because of the fact we lack sense of history.
So now that history has been returned,
yes.
Should we, because you just mentioned something, that history was not documented.
Yes.
The approach we gave to history, when it was, and now that it has been returned, should we continue with the same approach, or should we begin to document?
No, there must be a paradigm shift. When did the Civil War ended? There's no proper and objective documentation of what happened in the Civil War. And how do you learn from it if it's not properly documented? Every child in America knows about the American Civil War. If Americans' children are taught about George Washington, about Madison, about Kennedy, and all that, why wouldn't our own children be taught about it? Go and ask a child now about Obafemi Awolowo. He will tell you that you have made a mistake. That what he knows is Obafemi Martins, the footballer. Because they don't know about Awolowo. Ask our children, what M.K. Abiola, you are talking about it. Our children that were born in 1993, do you think they know anything about Abiola? I was in Germany when the Berlin Wall fell, 89-90. I was there in Germany, I was living in Germany. What happened? Go today and ask the children that were born 89-90 in Germany. They give you a graphic picture of what happened on that day because it was properly documented. When the Berlin Wall fell, we have the Eastern Germans, who were relatively poorer, coming to Western Germany, and they became xenophobic, trying to drive foreigners out of the country. What they did was they went back and started bringing Hitler's story, swastika, and all this thing. What happened? They stopped them at the spot because they knew what that thing would do to their destiny. But remember, many of them are not even the children of Second and First World War.
But
they learned from history.
Bringing it back home now. So for us in Nigeria, for children, who, now that history has been brought back, what would it do for them? It will give them that sense of patriotism. That is what you're saying.
Yes, and it gives them a sense of pride. As a small American, I worked in American this thing. Do you know what the children in America will tell you? If you ask him who he say, I am an American.
All right, we
have from the land of the free and the home of the brave. That is what they were taught in their school.
All right, we'll get to that point now that history has been returned. Emmanuel Muluku, thank you for your time on TVC Breakfast.
It's a pleasure.